Welcome to the TPS65987EVM and USB-C-PD-DUO-EVM video tutorial. We will be showing the details of the EVMs with common debug test points discussed on the TPS65987EVM. Then we will show an out-of-box demo and two demos where the configuration on the TPS65987EVM has been changed. First, we will discuss the hardware used in this tutorial. For this demo, we will be using the following: a USB-C PD laptop, a TPS65987EVM, the Power Duo source and sync evaluation module, and power and connection cables. For the rest of the video, I will be calling the TPS65987EVM the EVM, the Power Duo source board as the source board, and the Power Duo sync board as the sync board. The EVM has many features that are useful for debugging purposes. The source LEDs turn on when the EVM is sourcing 5, 9, 15, or 20 volts. They do not illuminate when the EVM is syncing power. The VBUS test point can be used to measure the voltage on VBUS. The power path jumper configuration is central to the board functionality. The jumpers determine whether the switch paths are used for syncing or sourcing and need to match the device firmware. The CC1 and CC2 test points can be used to monitor the CC lines to see the PD contract negotiation taking place. Next, we will demo the boards and their out-of-box configuration. The EVM comes with an out-of-box default flash image that can perform power delivery. When the EVM is connected to power, it can act as a power source. We will use the sync board to demonstrate the power contract negotiation with the EVM. When the sync board is connected and the 15-volt contract button is pushed, the sync board can sync up to 15 volts. The 15-volt LEDs on the EVM and sync board show this contract. If we look at the PD logs, we can also see this power negotiation taking place. The source, which is the EVM, sends its source capabilities by sending individual power data objects, or PDOs. These capture the power options the source offers. The sync then requests the source 15-volt PDO, then the source accepts. To see these contract negotiations in real time, an oscilloscope was connected to the VBUS and CC test points on the EVM. The EVM was connected to the sync board, and the 15-volt contract button was pushed on the sync board. The current was also read by attaching a load to the VBUS test point and then using a current probe to read the current, which is displayed on the oscilloscope. Taking a closer look at the scope captures, we can see that the CC line is toggling to show that the EVM can source or sync. When the sync board is connected, it shows only the 5-volt PDO, so the EVM sources 5 volts. When the 15-volt contract button is pushed on the sync board, the VBUS output voltage jumps from 5 volts to 15 volts. The EVM is now sourcing 15 volts at 3 amps. For our next demo, we will change the source PDOs on the EVM by using the TPS65987EVM application customization GUI tool. The GUI tool, shown here, allows you to reflash your board to configure it to your design. You can see a link to the GUI tool page in the description below. Here, I used the GUI to change the TX source capabilities registers to change the PDO from 20 volts at 3 amps to 20 volts at 2.25 amps. And then reflash the EVM. To flash the EVM with the new project, select the binary menu, press Flash from Current Project, select your USB to SPI adapter, read Current Region Offsets, and select OK. Once the board has been successfully flashed, be sure to cycle power on the EVM. When the sync board is connected and the 20-volt sync capability option is selected, a 20-volt contract is negotiated. The 20-volt LED lights up on the EVM and the sync board. Looking at the PD logs, the EVM first sends its PDOs. The 20-volt PDO now offers 2.25 amps of current. The sync requests the 20-volt 2.25 amp PDO. The EVM then accepts and begins to source 2.25 amps. The scope capture also shows this negotiation taking place. When the 20-volt button is pushed on the sync board, the EVM begins to source 20 volts. The current sent to the sync board is 2.25 amps. For our last demo, we will use the GUI tool to change the EVM sync PDOs. Here, the GUI is used to change the variable 5 to 20 volt 900 milliamp sync PDO to a fixed 9 volt 1.8 amp sync PDO. Now the source board is used so the EVM can operate as a sync. Though I select up to 20 volts of sourcing, the EVM can now only sync up to 9 volts, so the 9 volt LED comes on the source board. The PD log shows the source board PDOs offering up to 20 volts. The sync, which is the EVM in this case, requests 9 volts at 1.8 amps. The source accepts, and the agreed upon PD contract is now 9 volts at 1.8 amps. The scope shows this transition from 5 volts to 9 volts when the 20 volt button is pressed on the source board. The EVM begins syncing 9 volts at 1.8 amps. For more information on TI's power delivery solutions, please head to ti.com. There you can find user guides, video training, and engineering support on our E2E forum. Thank you for watching this video.